This is Missile Command, which came out in June of 1980 from Atari. It was designed by Dave Thurer and sold about 20,000 units. It was released in some European countries from Sega and also in Japan by Taito. The basic premise is that the Earth is under attack by aliens, and they're dropping all these weapons of mass destructions, and they're coming down to the six cities along the California coastline, and it's your job to defend California from these aliens. The bottom left, the bottom center, and the bottom right, you have three bases with batteries, and you take the cursor and you shoot it where you want these batteries to explode. If any of the missiles or satellites or planes or anything that gets into the path, they get destroyed. If you look at the controller, you have a trackball, so you can move really fast or really slow, and you have three buttons. Each of the three buttons controls one of the bases, either the Alpha, the Delta, or the Omega base. If you go through an entire wave, and you have cities that are left over, or weapons you haven't fired, you get bonuses. If any of these weapons of mass destructions come down and hit the cities, they get destroyed. When you're out of cities, the game is over. This game was originally called Armageddon. It came from a magazine story about satellites. And the president of Atari had seen this and he pushed it off to some of his programmers, and they decided he'd have a video game with missiles attacking California. And so that's how they came up with this. The cities at the bottom of the screen, there's six of them, represent Eureka, San Francisco, Los Angeles, San Diego, Santa Barbara, and San Luis Obispo. That's kind of tough to say. San Luis Obispo. You know, just call it SLO or something. I don't know. I can't pronounce it. But that's the six cities in California that you're defending. This was a very, very popular game for Atari. They ported it, you know, to all their little systems like the Atari 2600 and 5200 and so forth. Obviously, they're going to pump this up because it was a very popular game. There was a sequel, Missile Command 2, that was going to be a multiplayer game, but that had never come out. And you know what? Liberator came out years later from Atari. It was kind of like an unofficial sequel to this game. Not really, but it was considered an unofficial sequel. There are some weird things about this. If you get to 810,000 points, you get 150 extra cities. And in levels 255, 256, it wigs out and gives you tons of extra points. So there are parts of the game where you can really rack up the points. Kid Stuff Records, who came out with several of these type of, I don't know if you want to call them, you know, albums or whatever, but they had two talking stories about Missile Command as well. This was a really, really, really good game that came out for the time. This is one of the best games from the 1980s. It is Atari's Missile Command, June 1980. Game over, man. Game over.